check with it, but there were several.
Manville, Oak Ridge, Colfax, Julian, Climax, McLeansville, Gibsonville, Brown Summit, Archdale, Madison, Reedsville. None of them have a public safety plan. Stokesdale has one, but I haven't seen any minutes or anything in front of it for, I don't know if it's even active.
They appear to be an as needed committee.
And then, did you talk with the professionals to see what they thought?
The professionals?
The public safety professionals.
The ones that present every meeting now instead of having a.
Actually, when I got on the committee, I'm glad you looked it up. When I got on the committee, I noticed there was a spot for a EMS liaison. And I kept going to meetings, kept going to meetings and notices, and finally, I got in a conversation with either Roxanne or Scott, I can't remember, and asked them what the EMS stood for. Was it the emergency medical, or was it the emergency management? We finally, I believe, Scott, you helped me out here, we decided that it was going to be the emergency management system, is what was intended to be a liaison for the committee. So I called Don Campbell myself and invited him to the meetings and he started coming. The fire department was already coming and the sheriff's department was already coming.
Did you talk to them about reinstating the committee and they felt that it was a good thing to do?
A what?
A need for the town?
I think so. Public safety is really important for the town, just because my.
I asked the professional.
But also, you know, I had called the 7 applicants that had applied back then. And someone were interested, one of them didn't get a hold of, and I think I had one no on it. But like I said, it's just safety, and I know they took care of the generator. Also, I'm the one that got the generator manual going for the town. We did not have one. I looked into it and researched it and found it there. So yeah, I think it's a very important committee. And we can come and report back here as opposed to having. Now, what happened was we would do the meeting and then when we asked them for the report, other than Chris, the sheriff's department and the EMS guy would leave. Not unless they just wanted to stay. You know, we tell them just come and do your report and you can leave, and that's usually what they did. Same thing, you know, we can have the committee come in here, report that, they'll have to sit there and wait and listen to all the public comments, and then we finally get to their report. So yeah, I think it's a better time at a committee. They could spend 5 minutes and they're out of here, as opposed to tonight, I wasn't really sure, maybe 45 minutes.
If that's your concern, Councilman Pigman, we could always move number 8 up.
No, it's not just that. I'm just saying that's one of the things also. It's a very good committee, and there are safety concerns in this town. And that's where we want to direct it, the safety, you know, toward that committee.
So what I've seen, just in, you know, looking at other towns in Gilbert County and consulting with the professionals is that almost no towns have a public safety committee.
Well, that'd be different.
And they rely on the professionals, so I don't see why we would not rely on the professionals. None of the professionals feel that it's a necessary thing for the town. I'm sure they would all support it if we decided to have one.
There's hundreds of municipalities. I'd like to say that this was one of our most active committees. We have more applicants for this committee than any other committee. There's more people wanting to serve on this committee than any other committee that we have.
One thing that would set us aside from other municipalities is other municipalities provide those services. And if we're going to be a limited service town, like we are, I think one of the reasons that a lot of the municipalities that would have one is if the fire chief works for the town council, the police chief works for the town council, the EMS folks, works the town council, they need them to be reporting for them. They should have a place to come and say, hey, we're going to buy a fire truck, an ambulance, or 10 police cars. I think that's, if you see it in the community, I think a lot of times that's probably where it's there. And if I would venture to guess that Stokesdale had it because they had a deputy they contracted the county for. And that was probably the budget starting point for what could that be need? I mean, the car, a gun, a badge, uniform, that kind of thing. I tend to agree with the manager's recommendation. We've got the best relationship we've ever had. I think things are still being done, if anything else. And I thank you, Teresa, for getting EMS to start reporting, but we're getting their reports every month and keeping a good working relationship. I appreciate the citizens' interest in the community. But like I said, it was one of the hardest decisions I've ever made. I don't take safety lightly, but I don't think this committee ever worked towards safety again. I think it got off charge, and what we're doing now seems to work. We've got a good working relationship. I'd like to make a motion we take no action.
But if citizens are willing to serve this town.
There is a motion on the table to reinstate. There's a motion already on the table.
Then I'll make a substitute motion for no action.
I'll second.
Okay, there's for no action. And I do have a second. Any other discussion?
And Mr. Walker, what's your reasoning for making no motion, no action on that?
I have a discussion here. I think that when we first started this, the town council had only a clerk, and the public safety committee formed it. It did a wonderful job then. In fact, it took on the seniors program. It did a lot of other things rather than just the public safety committee. Actually, the sheriff and part of the people raised funds to help buy the generator. At that time, when we bought the generator, the sheriff donated $1,000 towards it.
The catch-all committee is what it was.
Exactly. And we did all that, and I think it served a wonderful purpose when we first began, and they took on more and more. But as we got a manager, a town administrator, and a manager, and our town grew, then the need was for less and less. So I think that's why we really don't need it at this point.
But the public safety was also responsible for getting the generator in case of emergency to the emergency shelter. That was one of our responsibilities. Mm-hmm. Who's doing that now?
The fire department
is handling that in an emergency situation.
I think the only time it was ever deployed, the fire department deployed it.
Stumble
for the tornadoes in 1996.
Wow. Are they still being maintained? The generator's still being maintained?
We just put new tires on it.
Yep.
Probably.
It was being cracked up and y'all were running it. We were actually getting ready to do actual, what's the word I want to use? Were we actually taking stuff over to the church to make sure it's going to work?
They do that too.
Yeah, has that been happening too? Y'all been taking the generator over to churches and making sure?
When's the last time it was connected and load tested?
Correct. That's what I'm looking for.
We haven't inspected it.
Nope, not the same thing.
But we should look into expanding the contract to have it load tested rather than
the facilities. I mean, I'm just concerned that, and this is why I think it's so important for public safety. You know, stuff in the generator is not getting done, so here we go. You know, you're not testing it, it's not being reported, and then you go to look it up and it ain't going to work, and then where's our mail?
They tested at least once a month, I know that.
Not the same thing. Load tested.
Right, load tested.
Let's have our manager look into amending the contract with the generator maintenance folks to include maybe load testing quarterly or twice a year.
Thank you.
At the two emergency shelters, both Center Church and Baptist Church.
That would be a good recommendation on safety plan.
Well, we don't have one right now, but if we're going to move forward, that's the way to do it.
And a good plan.
Well, I would think that would be a friendly amendment to your substitute motion.
Somebody else make it. I can't make my own friendly
well,
amendment.
Well, I make a friendly amendment to your substitute motion.
Okay. Okay.
What does that include that?
To include what?
No action plus.
No.
Having our manager looking to update our contract with them to include
the load test.
Load testing?
Yes, ma'am.
And that's the load testing for the generator? So you know what we're voting on here, okay. Any other discussion? Move forward on voting on the substitute motion. The substitute motion is no action.
With the friendly amendment of?
No action on reinstating the safety committee, the public safety committee, no action. And then the friendly amendment to have manager check to update the contract for load testing the generator.
And I'll accept the friendly amendment.
There's, okay. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
No? Three to two. There's one other thing, and this doesn't, this does not require a motion. The attorney suggested that the bill is a consensus issue, and it's a request to view the manager's personnel file, a request for counsel to agree, as this is, would be in conjunction with this annual review. Agree on that?
In what setting, Madam Mayor?
Oh, in closed session.
So there's.
Yeah, a closed session with open to the council.
There's a couple things there that we have to discuss, and I think we should probably do that in closed session.
This is.
So this is.
This has to be done, this is first before we do anything else.
I'd rather have a closed session first.
Where are you reading it?
This was what Bill Hill suggested. We talked about a closed session to review a personnel file, and he said we should discuss.
I'd rather have a closed session topic first.
Yeah, I think. Did we skip 9G?
No, because the.
Oh, 9G.
There's no closed session, we're going to recess to another time for the closed session for Bill Hill. He suggested choose whatever time we would like. He will either be there or he will have someone else there.
So we need to.
So let's talk about when we're going to recess tonight, the closed session to a future date. And let's just start with the 22nd, the 23rd.
Can I be clear, just for our court's benefit, so what we're talking about is actually recessing the meeting, not the closed session, but for the purpose of finishing the closed session.
Recess this meeting for the purpose of the closed session. When the attorney can't be present. And.
So you're going to do the 22nd?
Thursday, evening, Friday, Thursday.
Thursday evening, for me.
What's for you, Thursday? Everybody going on Thursday?
Thursday, the 22nd.
The 22nd, yes.
Or I'm flexible too, so I'm not.
Yes.
There could be some sort of error.
No. At what time?
What time?
7:00 PM, 6:00 PM.
Seven?
Seven.
Making sound certain?
Okay.
February 22nd.
It doesn't require a motion, we're going to recess to.
Because that does require, that does require.
We need a motion. Town hall is okay, could we do it here?
The historical committee is mean, but we could probably move you guys upstairs for that meeting, if that's all right. Would that work for you?
You're talking about this Thursday, the last.
The 22nd.
I'd rather, if they're meeting there, I'd rather not have a closed session yet.
Correct.
I agree. I agree. Could you check for your community center?
We could, court could check the availability of the community center.
Okay, court can check the community center for the location. We need a motion to.
Madam Mayor, do we want to double back?
I've got one other, but there is something, before we go into recess, there is another item for the council to discuss. Before we go into recess.
9G.
And just one quick answer, we actually had the Board of Adjustment scheduled for that night here. They won't be meeting, so we already have the place.
Okay.
Got it.
Okay, so that should be okay at the 7:00 time.
It was good that we had that discussion, but there is the request to view the personnel file. And this part is necessary for the evaluation, the annual review.
I think we could address that at the next meeting.
That's what I really.
Well, that's the purpose, no, that's the purpose.
No, it's not.
I just talked with Mr. Hill today.
Look, the purpose of that meeting is to review, to investigate a complaint charge grievance by or against an individual's public office or employee.
That was removed, I thought.
We actually made a little mistake, I think, when we started the meeting. When we adopted the consent agenda, we ideally should have removed tonight's closed session.
Okay.
Well, we're going to recess to the.
Since we adopted it, but we only have these two listed.
Right, and this is not the same. If you need another closed session statute for.
Actually, this is specifically what the attorney had said. Request to review the manager's personnel file, request for the council to agree that this is in conjunction with the annual review, and this is still part of preserving the attorney-client privilege.
I'll tell you what, I will agree to it if Mr. Hill says that in closed session, to me, and face to face.
Okay.
Better be in a closed session.
All right. Yeah, we don't have to vote on that. That's okay?
Are you assuming you have a consensus, Madam Mayor?
I'm going to convey what John said. Question here. We don't have to vote on this. It's a consensus issue. So, yeah, the other, I know there's people that have requested, there's other people that have requested.
You don't have consensus.
You said provide it.
Not until Mr. Hill says so in that closed session, then because
we can discuss it at the.
What the public doesn't understand is there's a lot going on here, and we want to be very careful about what we do or allow access to without the attorney present.
So I would make a motion to recess this meeting until February the 22nd at 7 p.m. here at the community center.
For the purpose of closed session.
For the purpose of having a closed session to consult with our attorney.
Is that the rest of the meeting?
It's just to continue the meeting, so.
I'll second.
That's it.
Right.
And to continue the meeting, yes.
Which is out of the.
So we will not adjourn tonight.
Let it recess.
Just recess.
Okay, can I go back to 10D before we recess? Do we go through 10D?
I would like to go through 10D.
Okay, before we recess, all right. I had originally had something, the thing that I brought up was actually an update, and then we got into the recess discussion. But let's go back to 10D and vote.
Mayor, we have a motion in a second. So.
Recess the meeting.
So are we going to, are you asking for the motion to be withdrawn so we can discuss 10D before we recess?
Yes. Would you withdraw the motion to discuss 10D as long as this.
In 9D.
No,
get 9D.
9D and 10D.
Okay, all right. Withdraw the motion for the recess to discuss 9D.
We got it.
Right, 10D.
We didn't get to speak last week. Jeez.
You know what?
I mean this.
Let's discuss those things at the recess meeting. Let's go ahead with the recess motion and.
Before we enter into the closed session, we can discuss that.
Yes.
We probably can't skip around this much.
I didn't know that you had either.
The manager's probably reports up this.
I have two quick things if you're recognizing me from 9G.
Oh, I do.
Just under my report, water feasibility study, Timmons. is still working on maps to present, so we're getting there, but they're not quite done with their work, but it's nearing the end. With Greenway Progress, Stuart is still working on that project to be ready to present to us, and those are the only two things I have to report, other than you're correct that A6 is the correct, also the correct closed session for both agreements that's outlined and for performance evaluation. So that, those two will do for the closed session.
But the next Timmons Group meeting, Water, is Thursday at 2 p.m., correct?
Timmons is coming to...
Thursday at 2.
Just with the town, it's not a larger...
Correct, yes.
When are they coming?
They're coming to meet with Carrie and myself with, in reference to the map that each council member has come by and spoken about.
I will be there also.
Is it 2?
2 o'clock on Thursday.
2 o'clock Thursday.
Incidentally, just to clarify, the item that I had requested, which did not require a motion, that was under 10D, and then we digressed into the recess discussion. So, very sorry if that's confusing.
Well, if we're doing 10D, I have an NPO meeting scheduled at 2 p.m. February 28th.
Anything exciting here?
But that doesn't interfere with that.
So the other thing I would say is, along with the update, do you have something, Teresa? I'm sorry. Teresa, did you have something?
No. It's hard to hear y'all because...
I know, I've complained about that. I'm very...
Can you hear me now? Oh, yes, I hear you.
They were good last time. It was much better.
Well, I'm asking him what she said, and I got it down. He said the 28th.
What's the 28th?
Say what you will say, I'll tell you if I remember what it was.
Elizabeth Burkett from Elmhurst Estates stopped in with some concerns about the traffic, especially the left turns coming to Elmhurst on the 220.
That's
why you're here. Reese and I went there one morning around 7:40 and just kind of noticed some of the traffic. There was one person maybe had a little bit of difficulty coming out of there, but everybody seemed to navigate that turn okay. I didn't see that there was any danger. But I think it's worth maybe some further discussion.
I did talk to the station engineer and he's going to check on that.
Maybe some sort of sensor to stop traffic that someone's getting ready to pull out and make a left hand turn. Maybe something more.
He didn't have any information on it. I'll email you to see if we can check on it.
Maybe go back to
that. Thank you.
Okay. Are we still on 10D?
Yeah, go.
Okay. Yay. Just two things quickly is someone had called me and wanted to know, they wanted me to give them a breakdown of the $1,248.87 that the Northwest reported for the retreat. They wanted a breakdown of where did you get that cost. And the second thing I have was, what happened to the January newsletter that was supposed to go out to welcome Lance and the new members? What happened to that?
I put it on hold to deal with the struggling council.
Really? Seriously?
Yes.
Come on, put our face out there, Scott. Come on. You can do it.
I have the breakdown. I can email it to you tomorrow.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much. You're going to send it to everybody.
I'll send it to everybody. Thank you.
Oh.
On the February 2 p.m. meeting you were talking about, what will you be voting on?
February.
You mentioned
NPO meeting.
The NPO meeting. What are we
on the 28th?
Yeah,
26th. Pull the mic in close. We can't hear you.
The NPO meetings are Metropolitan Planning Organization downtown.
The meeting staff will present the draft fiscal year 2018-19 Unified Planning Work Program. There will be a presentation from the Piedmont Land Conservancy about Piedmont Legacy Trails.
was confusing because it's not.
Oh, I thought she had mentioned voting on something at that time.
Well, the MPO votes on it for the whole Metropolitan Planning Organization. So I'm the small town representative that represents the small towns. So I just usually report when there is one, if anybody's interested in attending and hearing about it or has any input they want me to take.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
How many do you have there?
2 to 4 is the scheduled time, but we don't always go that late.
And do we need to vote on the motion? The motion to recess this meeting to Thursday, the 22nd at 7 p.m.
Here.
Here at the community center.